Okay, I wanted to give you a short little video on how to replace a servo. Everybody should know how to replace a servo. It takes about 10 minutes in the field to do it, and you can get your units back up and working. Common problem would be is that your servo is not working or is partially working. First thing to check before you go and replace the servo is to check the wiring harness that comes in to the main unit. You unplug it, and there's a little tab in the back. Take the connector out, examine that all the pins are at the same level, and then re-plug it back in to your receiver. This assures that it hasn't loosened up in any way by going through it. The next thing to check is actually the connector at where your servo goes. And usually on the new bumper boys, they use see-through plastic so you can see it. And you simply, if you wanted to check it, you just check it and make sure that it's there. On the other ones, you may have to cut off the black heat shrink. After checking those two, as long as your electronics is confirmed to be working, then it's a fairly simple job to replace the servo. The main thing that you need, and you should always have a test kit in your truck, and that is a spare servo, or what we call a test servo. And simply you unplug it from here and you plug it back in the wiring harness here. You line up the wires. For the ones that you might not be able to tell, you can just reverse the connector if it didn't work one way, and it should work the other way. So the first thing before you take anything off of the mechanism is strictly to take the servo off. And you can just use a box cutter to do that. And what I usually do is just cut these wire straps off here. That side and the other side. And then strictly do a slice on this side of your heat shrink and then on the other side, and pull apart your connector. Then insert the new servo and test it and see if it works. That confirms that it is a servo problem. And then the only thing that you have to do is undo these four screws, which are here on your servo. So you undo the four screws, you take the wire ties off the side, and you basically slide in your new servo and use some either a hair dryer or a lighter to put the heat shrink back on your unit. So it's a 10-minute job. You should always be able to get back in operational as long as you have a test servo.